Hello guys, Emily here. Today, I want to talk about the new Substance Painter LiveLink for Blender. This is the first iteration of the new Python-based plugins from Substance Painter, and also is the first version that supports the new UDIMS workflow. Since the Adopt team fully changed how exports and plugins work inside Painter, I had to do some major changes, so the way it works is a little different from the previous versions. Still, I try to keep it simple and as similar as possible to how it has worked so far. Also consider that there are still some limitations for Python plugins, the main one being that you cannot export geometry from Painter yet. Hopefully, this will be added soon enough by the Adopt team. So let's get started. From the Gumroad page, download the zip of the version 2.1.0. And extract it. Inside, you'll find a folder called ShowLSPLink. Copy it and paste it in the Python's plugin folder from Painter, located in Documents, Algorithmic, Substance Painter, Python, Plugins. Please make sure that you're using this path, otherwise it won't work. Then open Painter. If you install the plugin correctly, you will either see the icon of the live link on the right side of the UI, or the window already docked somewhere in the UI. Now we need to verify the license and install the Blender client. To verify the license, open the plugin and go to the Configuration tab, paste your license in the key field and click Verify. If successful, the email will be filled and a success message will appear in the log. Now, to install the Blender client, select the Blender version and this will automatically set the recommended path to install the add-on. In my case, I will select 2.90 and click the Install button. Now we can see a success message appear in the log to inform us that the Blender client was installed correctly. We can verify it by clicking the folder button. To finalize the Blender installation, now we need to enable the add-on. So we open Blender, go to Edit Preferences Add-on, we search for Xolotl and enable it. Then we restart Blender and we are ready to use the plugin. Instead of checking every field of the plugin, I think it's better to see how it works in a usual workflow. Let's open Blender and Painter. The first thing we notice is that as soon as I open both apps, they are both connected. In Painter, we can see the ID of the Painter instance, the available apps, in this case only Blender is available, the available renders for the app, for Blender's are Cycle, CV and Octane, and the presets for each render. On Blender, we can see the Blender instance ID, the available Painter instances, and as you can see, each other's ID match. Once you select the render and the preset, all the available maps for that preset will appear in the Channels tab. The maps that are shown in the Mesh section are the basic maps needed for a PBR material, and the ones in the optional can be used depending on the material, for example, the emissive and opacity. Let's begin by sending a geo from Blender to Painter. All we need to do is decide the normal map to be used, the initial resolution, the tangent space, if we want to include the cameras, and the workflow either default or UDIMS. So we select the geo and the camera and click Send. If we have not opened a project in Painter, a new project will be created. If something is already open, depending on what we have in the General section of the Configuration tab, it can either do nothing and inform of an error in the log, or automatically close the current project and open a new one. Now, with the geo on Painter, let's set this lava material and enable the emissive map. Next, we need to decide how we're going to export the maps. First, we select the output path. If you have not selected anything yet, the default export path from Algorithmic will be selected. Then the format and the bit depth, the base size of all the maps, the padding and the deletion if necessary. These settings will be the default settings to be used by all the texture sets and all the maps, but thanks to the new export system of Painter, we can now add some extra configurations. To add these extra configurations, we add rules. For example, this rule is of the type format and is changing the image bit depth of the normal map from 8 to 16. We can add as many rules as we want with the plus button and they can be applied at UDIMS level, at map level or at texture set level. And the rules can change the image format, the size and the padding. Once we have configured everything, we can just click the Save button to keep the configuration even if we close Painter. Finally, we select the test set we want to export and click Send. As you can see, the material was created and all is working as expected. I'll do an extra video explaining UDIMS, the different shader networks, and how their rules work, so don't forget to subscribe.